we have a dense fog advisory, mm-hmm. so we really have to be watchful when we're out on the roads today.
Yeah, you'll be driving around and you'll hit the areas of dense fog, and then you may drive out of it, so you could be going the posted speed limit and then hit that fog,
right.
and you can't really see much in front of you. Visibilities are down to a quarter mile in a few locations. We'll get to those in a moment. First, we'll start you off, though. Outside, look at the DOT cameras here on 894. Not much fog in that direction. Maybe a little light fog hanging near the street lights there and some damp roads across the area. Now, across southeastern Wisconsin, we do have kind of varying amounts of fog across the region. A little light fog hanging out over the lake right now. And let's check out the dense fog advisories across southeast Wisconsin. Everyone in gray here, the shaded counties, that's a dense fog advisory until 10 a.m. this morning. Make sure to use the low beam headlights as you're traveling during the pre-dawn hours. Visibility is across the area, lowest in Kenosha and also in Rock County for Janesville. Visibility is there a quarter mile. That is considered dense fog. Not quite dense fog in Milwaukee, but still three quarters of a mile at Mitchell International Airport. If you have an early morning flight, not bad to log on and just check to make sure that is on time. Temperature-wise across the area, sometimes you get fog in those damp roads. You are concerned about some icing conditions. Not really the case. We're well above freezing this morning. It's 36 in Brown Deer, 39 in Tulsa. Still 40 in Brookfield, mid-30s in Waukesha. And on the south side of Milwaukee, it's 39 degrees, while you jump up north, 36 right now in Mequon in Ozaukee County. Temperature-wise across the area, I mentioned earlier, could be a little icy sidewalk or driveway near Beaver Dam and Watertown. They're right at 32 degrees. Otherwise, the rest of the area is above freezing, just damp roadways here in the metro area for your morning commute. Also may need the wipers going with a little patchy drizzle here and there. Could be a spotty rain shower this morning. Then this afternoon, we'll watch a couple snow showers. We'll try to wrap into the backside of the storm system. Really no snow accumulation expected for today or into this evening. Now let's go hour by hour through your forecast. That band of heavy accumulating snow, that's falling apart pretty quickly this morning. We'll look for cloudy skies, a gray day, and a little drizzle from time to time this morning. Then by the afternoon, possibility of a couple flurries or a snow shower across our area. This is at 8 p.m., and if we would see this area of snow showers develop, there may be 1 or 2 tenths of an inch of snow, just a very light dusting in a couple backyards, while most areas see no snow accumulation today. Then by tomorrow morning, some clouds across the area. Could be some flurries around on your Tuesday. Chilly temps with highs only in the 30s. For today, 38 degrees. You notice we're in the upper 30s now. Temps will hold nearly steady from the morning into the afternoon. Again, this looks impressive, but this is a spotty rain or snow shower. A couple flurries wrap up our day. And then Tuesday and Wednesday, looking for daytime highs in the mid-30s. You'll certainly want that heavier coat for the early and middle part of this week. By Friday and Saturday, we'll try to jump to the low 40s with a chance of a rain or snow shower to start off your weekend.